when I'm in touch with myself as a spiritual being rather than my name, my physical form, my external identity, the profession that I have, my designation, etc., in that spiritual consciousness of being that being within, I'm in touch with my own conscience. My conscience is awake and alert and is able to give me guidance. And for most people today, it's very difficult to hear the very quiet voice of the conscience speak inside, maybe because they don't give it enough time. Because you need to let your mind become quiet, otherwise the mind is like the chattering monkey that's on and on and on. And of course, all the things that we're surrounded with, all our devices are adding to that non-stop flow of information. And there isn't a moment just to stop and be still and ask myself the question, should I not? And because we're missing out on that, then we get pulled into whatever becomes the social norm. And you can see how from a society generally that had morals and values, there was a downward slide to a society where maybe people didn't bother too much about morals, and maybe they knew what they were doing was wrong, but they still carried on doing it. So you get to the state of immorality, but then you get to a state of amorality, which is quite normal nowadays, where people will say, oh, don't even talk about morals anymore. So amorality, where morals don't have an influence on human life and policies and the way in which things are going. And so definitely the moral compass, the conscience, awakens through silence, through spirituality, knowing myself. And that's also the guideline that gives me the principles on which I work within my field of expertise, my profession, the policies we create. You see some of the debates that go on in the world, and there's a long list of them. And we're not really looking at the values that are innate to human beings. And so we're going totally against that in so many different situations. Maybe it's a question of building more and more casinos. Maybe it's the question of lowering the age of consent. Maybe it's the issue of racism. Maybe it's all sorts of things like this that we're having to deal with. But ethics and values are connected with the spirit within, and spirituality means exploring my own being within. And so yes, definitely spirituality allows the awakening of the conscience, the moral compass, and to allow ethics to come back into our lives and public life also.